Assalamu alaikum friends. Welcome to this MATLAB tutorial. Today I am going to teach you how to design closed loop buck converter using PI controller in MATLAB Simulink software. Furthermore, in the end of this video, I will discuss more than 10 new research ideas on how this closed loop buck converter can be used to complete your bachelor degree FYP project, master degree research, are one of the PhD research objectives. Look at the figure which shows the block diagram of closed loop buck converter. It may be noted that highlighted portion is similar to the open loop buck converter model. It means we have to design the bottom circuit to convert this open loop buck converter into closed loop buck converter model. Friends, before going to start its designing, I want to highlight here that I have already made the video on this open loop buck converter model with the title on how to design buck converter in MATLAB Simulink software. Therefore, I would like to strongly suggest you to watch this video first for understanding the basics of this model. In order to save the time, I am going to start the designing from the closed loop buck converter portion. Let's start. First, come to MATLAB screen. You can see I have already opened the open loop buck converter Simulink model. Let's first save it. You may save it with any name of your choice and in any folder. Look at the figure. To design the closed loop buck converter, first we need the constant block having the reference voltage of 5 volt. It is because we want the output voltage of 5 volt. To get this, go to Simulink library. Take this constant block from here and bring it in the model. Now double click on this block. Put here 5 volt value and press OK. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that now we need to connect the subtract block. Therefore, come to model again. Take the subtract block from here and bring it in the model. Connect the constant block with the positive terminal of the subtract block. Look at the figure again. Now we need to connect the PID controller block. It may be noted that here discrete PID controller is used. Therefore, come to model again. Take this PID controller block from here and bring it in the model. Connect this PID controller block here. Now double click on this block. Click on discrete time in order to make it discrete controller. Now click on PID advanced option. Enable this limit output. Put here the upper and lower limit of 0.9 and 0.1 respectively. Friends, most of the times PI controller is preferred as compared to PID controller. Therefore, it's now your choice which controller you want to use here. I am going to use PI controller here. For this purpose, in the controller section, select the PI controller and press OK. Look at the figure again. Now we need to connect the pulse width generator. Therefore, come to model. Take this PWM block from here and bring it in the model. Connect this block with the output of the PI controller block. Double click on this block. As we know that the switching frequency used for buck converter model is 25 kHz. Therefore, put here switching frequency of 25 kHz and press OK. Now connect the output of this PWM block with the MOSFET gate pulse input. Similarly, connect the second port of this subtract block with the output of the buck converter in order to complete the closed loop buck converter circuit. Now we need the display block to see the values. Therefore, take this display block from here and bring it in the model. Connect this display block at the feedback loop. Change the simulation time to 1 second. Friends, at this stage our model is completed. Now you can run the simulation by clicking on this play button. You can see the output voltage is still not equal to 5 volt. Friends, our model is correct, but now we have to tune the parameters of the PI controller again and again in order to get the desired output voltage. After several simulations, the parameters of P and I, which provides the satisfactory response, are 0.01 and 5 respectively. Therefore, put the values of proportional and integral gain as 0.01 and 5 respectively. Now run the simulation again to see the results. Double click on this scope. You can see it has provided the desired output voltage. Friends, now I am going to discuss the last important point, which I mentioned in the beginning of this video, that what other research ideas can be added in this model to extend this research, to complete your bachelor degree FYP project, master degree research, or one of the PhD research objectives. Friends, as we have observed that PID controller needs proper tuning of its parameters to provide the satisfactory response. Therefore, now we have two other options. In the first option, we may replace this PID controller with latest intelligent controllers such as fuzzy logic controller. In that case, the topic will become fuzzy logic controller based closed loop buck converter. I have already made the videos on fuzzy logic controller series to understand its basic with the title How to Implement Fuzzy Logic Control in MATLAB Simulink. This fuzzy series consists of 3 parts. Therefore, you may watch this video series if you want to apply fuzzy logic controller on this model. Furthermore, you can also use artificial neural network as an intelligent controller. Again, I have already made the videos on artificial neural network series to understand its basic with the title How to Implement Artificial Neural Network in MATLAB Simulink. This ANN series consists of 4 parts. Therefore, you may watch this video series if you want to apply artificial neural network on this model. Furthermore, artificial neural network also has many types, such as radial basis function neural network, or probabilistic neural network, or wavelet neural network, convolution neural network, support vector machine, deep learning, and its various types. You may also use the combination of artificial neural network and fuzzy logic controller, namely adaptive neurofuzzy inference system. Friends, I have already made the videos on adaptive neurofuzzy inference system series to understand its basic with the title How to Implement Adaptive Neurofuzzy Inference System in MATLAB Simulink. This ENFIS series consists of 2 parts. Therefore, you may watch this video series if you want to apply ENFIS controller on this model. In the second option, we can use the PID controllers and try to optimize its parameters using the latest optimization techniques, such as ant colony optimization technique. In that case, your topic will become ant colony optimization based closed loop buck converter. You may also use bee colony optimization technique, particle swarm optimization technique, firefly optimization technique, bacterial foraging optimization technique, or you may use any other latest optimization technique in this model to extend your research. Friends, I have shared with you more than 10 new research ideas that can be used on this closed loop buck converter model. For your convenience, I have uploaded this closed loop buck converter model in the form of link in the description section of this video. You may download it from there. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel, and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.